Anyone who won a lifetime supply of something, what did you win, and are they still supplying it to you?
I won a year's supply of milkshakes from Chic Fil-A. They gave me 52 coupons for one free milkshake, large. And it was not limited to one per transaction.
My sister won a lifetime supply of sour warhead candies. But they stopped sending them after a few years too. I think it was a blessing that they stopped actually.
Or she'd be super popular from giving it away. Sour, as sophomore in high school, was gifted 5 pounds bag of Jolly Ranchers. Ate a lot, but gave most away. To this day I hate Jolly Ranchers.
Was it a sour face pucker contest? Because that's what I won. I received candy for like 5 years.
Related, I saw the dentist more than ever during that time.
That's a sucky employee perk. Once you're fired, all your friends are pissed at you too.
As someone in manufacturing, that kind or reasonable feedback is super valuable and welcomed.
Old Redditor here. I won a lifetime subscription to Playboy magazine in 1969. I was a senior in college. It was the raffle grand prize at a big party weekend. The subscription has followed me around the world ever since.
Don't anyone say those old issues are worth something.
Except for the very first year issues, they are worthless.
And who saves old magazines?
Also, the articles haven't been much to get excited about for quite a while now.
I'm currently bracing for a final issue arrival or notification of same.
It has been a lovely run.
I imagine I'd be the idiot who'd see the gray mandem, think weird, then eat it and never know I want anything.
Except it said all over the packages in big letters and was a huge deal at the time.
I was always afraid I'd accidentally eat one without noticing, but it also had some big notice inside the package if it was a winner.
Not a lifetime supply, but I once won a year of free Grubhub. It wasn't a full calendar year, but it was $1K in free food, and their system kept track of how much was left each time I ordered.
Pretty sweet deal, especially since I was in college at that time.
I won a year's supply of Pepsi when I was in 6th grade. It was one of those grocery store contests. I entered about 30 times a day and surprise, they drew my name.
We had to go to a distribution plant and pay the deposit on 16 cases of Dr. Pepper, my fave, enough for a can a day.
My dad made me get half diet, lame.
I had all 16 cases stacked in my bedroom. I'd take a six-pack to school every day.
I was pretty popular for a couple of months.
They say a lot of people who win millions in the lottery blow it all and end up broke. I can attest to that.
It was good while it lasted.
When I was a kid, Crayola was running a Create a New Color contest.
If you won, your color went in one of their big boxes of crayons, and you got a lifetime supply of crayons when they retire colors and make new ones.
I made swamp green and won.
They send me a new big box of crayons 1 to 2 times a year, and have been doing it for 20 plus years.
That's pretty cool.
Nothing like cracking open a fresh box of Crayola.
Immediately my brain starts playing the Crayola factory piece from Mr. Rogers.
Now if only we can meet the creator of the macaroni and cheese crayon.
I have a lot of words to share.
6-year-old me has a particular bone to pick with whoever made candy apple red.
Sitting in my doctor's office one day, and I find a card for entry into the lifetime subscription lottery for Nat Geo. 17-year-old me slips this card into my pocket to take home and fill out.
I noticed that you needed a subscription number to complete the form, so I take it off the label on the cover.
Long story short, I won my doctor a lifetime subscription to National Geographic.
My parents won a lifetime supply of diapers for me when I was about 3 months old.
It was a contest where I apparently had won on a cute picture.
They received 3 years' worth of diapers and figured I wouldn't need more after that.
They were right, so far.
Damn, when you hit leaky old age, you're going to be calling that company.
I was expecting this to end with you saying that your grandfather had a bitchin' farm because of this, but I'm even happier with how this ended up.
My mother used to do sweepstakes. She also used my name and address for them too. Well, I won a year's supply of Purina dog food. They sent 52 coupons for up to 25 pounds bags. My dog at the time, Doobie, was a squat 35 pounds Beagle Yellow Lab mix, and he was just fine with the small bags per week. So, we donated the vast majority of them to a local animal shelter. My brother won a lifetime supply of Twinkies. He would get a couple large boxes a month. Then the company went bankrupt. New company does not honor the lifetime supply agreement. What a fantastic marketing plan for a failing car wash. I bet the owner was saying, hey, offer a lifetime of free car washes on the radio to get people to come in. If we close in a week, we won't have to honor it anyway. Not me, but one of my buddy's family won a lifetime supply of bread. They delivered on the bread, but the catch is that it came yearly on a big truck. Every kind you could imagine, but way too much bread for one family to handle. So they ended giving most of it away to people who live in our small town before it molded. I won a year's worth of free dinners at Texas Roadhouse. You only got one dinner a month for the year, so 12 dinners. I went every month and it was awesome.